Brian, thank you for a really inspiring message this morning. I think we're all clearly challenged, thank you. Just by way of announcements before we wrap up, I have a letter from the council. I just want to read that, so are you ready? Okay. Okay, ours in North Down Borough Council. 26th of November 2019. Dear Trevor, as you will know, last year all the churches in Holywood united to organise the Holywood Hope programme, reaching over 12,000 people in 7 days, and you'll remember it well. Feedback from the town residents was overwhelmingly positive. As a result, we at Ards and North Down Borough Council wish to honour the diversity of the church, wish to honour the diversity of the church groups with the first ever Holywood Church of the Year Awards. Wow, okay. The ceremony will be held in Queen's Leisure Centre on Thursday the 12th of December at 8 p.m. All will be most welcome, albeit tickets will be available on a first-come, first-served basis. Tickets can be reserved free by calling or emailing the Mayor's office. Contact details found below. I look forward to hearing from you. Yours truly, Alderman Bill Carey, Mayor of Ards and North Down Borough Council. So, there you are. Take note. Thank you.
Well, would you believe it?
Well, I nominate Simon for the Worst Joke Award. I think he's been pulling the crackers early this year.
I'm very sorry to disappoint you, Ivan, but is there any way I can clause back into your good books?
Oh, not again, Simon. I rest my case.
Do you know if we're up for any awards?
That's a really good question, Jennifer, and one I don't have the answer to, but I know we'll get really positive feedback the last time we hosted the United Holywood prayer meeting.
Well, I for one cannot wait.
Well, isn't this all terribly exciting? Goodness me, they've gone to a lot of trouble, haven't they?
Seen this list of categories? Best praise and worship, spongiest communion bread, friendliest welcomer, tidiest Sunday school store, most prayers in a prayer meeting. They have really thought of everything, haven't they?
What do you think our best chances, Dad?
Well, it's difficult to say. I bet Ivan fancied his chances in the friendliest welcomer. But I wouldn't like to assume.
Why is that?
Well, you know what they say about people who assume?
No.
Well, I don't want to ruin the surprise.
Welcome your host for this evening, Jay Ingham.
Hello there, one and all. Welcome to the Holywood Church of the Year Awards. Probably wondering why it's me hosting and not someone more famous like the Mayor or maybe Barra Best. Well, Barra Best is cruising up the River Ban for an up-and-coming TV series, and everyone else at the council's tied up tonight with the election count. Anyway, I promise that's the last disappointment of the evening until we start dishing out the awards. Without any further ado, let's get on with the show. We've got 15 awards up for grabs, building up to the biggie. At the end, Church of the Year Award. First up, it's the friendliest welcomer.
If I don't win this, there's something seriously wrong.
And the winner is Jack Woods from Holywood Methodist Church.
Jack Woods, no way, I've been absolutely robbed in this.
Calm down, it's just a word, it's not the end of the world, Alan. It is to me.
We come to our final word of the evening. This is one we've all been waiting for, or should I say, be our final awards for this evening. We have decided to split this into three separate awards. Small Church of the Year, Medium Church of the Year, and Large Church of the Year. We'll start off with the Holywood Small Church of the Year, with less than 15 members, and the winners are Redburn Community Church.
Oh, thank you very much. Oh, thank you very much. Very, very good. Thank you. Oh, wonderful. It's a beautiful award. Thank you very much. Well, first of all, I have a small speech prepared. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. Council Representative. On behalf of Redburn Community Church, I'm really honoured to accept this fantastic and amazing award. Well, first of all, I'd like to offer commiserations to all of the many other churches that missed out on this award.
Axel Trevor, if I could just point this out to you.
All right.
This award, uncontested.
Oh, all right.
You're the only church in Hollywood with less than 15 members.
Okay. What about Pastor Joe's New Life Church?
They have just passed the 15 members.
Oh dear. Oh, okay. Well, that's good. I see. Well, anyway, still, I do think we deserve this award. And there are many phrases that would spring to mind. Small but mighty. It's not quality, but as we know, it's not quantity, it's quality that counts. And we know that the dynamite comes in small packages. Just let's hope we don't explode anytime soon. In fact, if you see Ivan, the look on his face, you think he's going to explode anytime. Anyway, since our founding over 30 years ago, we've come, I think, a long, long way. 0.8 of a mile, to be exact, from the bottom of My Lady's Mile right up into the community centre. It might not sound like a lot, but we'll try walking it on a cool Sunday morning. I'd like to thank a few people without whom this would not be possible, and our church wouldn't even be here today. First of all, Keith Gurner, the founder of our fellowship, the dearly departed Pastor Margaret, our roster of visiting speakers, Phil Craig, Brian Jingles, Henry Middleton, Lorraine Waddell, our sister church in Larne Christian Fellowship, the Barnabas Network of Churches, Shanti Lily Raji and Good News Ministries in India, Claire Newell and the team at Ards and North Down Borough Council for the use of the hall, the Ordnance Survey for quite literally putting us on the map, Frank Mitchell for today's brilliant weather forecast. It was beautiful today. Kellogg's.
We're having a few technical difficulties, Trevor.
Oh,
but humble as ever.
Oh yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And next up is the Hollywood Medium Church of the Year for congregation over 15 members but less than 75.
Beautiful, isn't it? Absolutely beautiful.
It's absolutely beautiful.
Do you know, is this the first award we've ever won as a church?
Yeah, I think you might be right there. Well, I better not wear it down by holding it too much. I'll put it down. Okay, folks, well, let's get on with this evening's service, I suppose. Get rid of these. Oh, I better not put them near that. Okay, so let's see, where do we get to? So let's have a wee look at Matthew chapter. Okay, you are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its flavour, how shall it be seasoned? It is good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men.
Who turned out the lights?
Probably just a power cutter or something, huh?
The trophy's gone!
Let's forget about the trophy. Let's get the dodgy wiring sorted out for the carol service.
And the heating while they're at it is absolutely freezing in here.
Folks, let's make no mistake about it. This is no coincidence. This is an act of treachery. Anya.
Isn't it crazy that someone would stoop so low to steal a small trophy?
Terrible, terrible. Linda, how are the mugshots coming along?
Nearly there. Nearly there. I'm getting there.
Dad, where are we at?
Redburn Community Church, Jackson Road, Hollywood.
No, not physically. I mean, where are we at with the investigation, you idiot?
Okay, so we have secured a 100 metre cordon right around the building. Chief suspects, Breeze Carlton.
Uh-huh, okay.
Very suspicious. Henrietta Finlay.
Yep.
Jean Ramsey. Alison Duncan.
Okay.
Oh, and Rory McIlroy.
And what leads us to that conclusion?
Okay, so Breeze Carlton used to live locally, member of the church.
Yeah.
Henrietta lives kind of locally. Jean Ramsey,
yeah,
lives locally, haven't seen her for a while.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Alison Duncan lives, yeah, locally, of course, as, yeah, we know. And Rory McIlroy hasn't won a trophy in years.
And lives locally.
And lives locally.
Yes, okay. So what's next then?
Okay, well, it's just a hunch. We haven't interviewed them yet.
Well, what are you waiting for? Come on, chop chop.
Yeah, well, Jennifer's got the CCTV.
Okay, right, okay, I'll go see her. Go, go, go. Jennifer, I hear the CCTV camera footage is ready.
Oh, Simon, we've got the CCTV footage here from the night of the theft.
Ah, right.
So there's only one angle that the camera can take, but it should have picked up a thief if it had come through that door.
Ah, you would think so.
Wait, what was that, Simon?
Yeah. Ach, that's only Keith the caretaker. He's brushing the floor. There's no way it could be him. He's got no motive or anything. Right, now this was roughly the time that the lights went out. Blast, it's inconclusive. We're gonna have to solve this one the hard way.
Simon, have we got any leads yet?
Yes, actually, we've got microphone lead, VGA cable.
No, Simon, leads in the investigation.
Oh, leads in the, oh, right. No, we don't, unfortunately.
Can you imagine the public outcry if news spreads that we've lost our award?
We better hope it doesn't come to that.
Simon, I found this in the car park. It was under the windscreen wiper.
Oh. I have information. Meet me at the Hollywood subway at 10 p.m. this evening. Come alone. Oh.
You're late.
Yeah, sorry about that. Thought you meant the Hollywood branch of the Subway fast food chain.
Utterly useless.
Ah, so Desi, long time no see. How are you?
Good to see you. I'm undercover. My code name's Tina Turner.
Okay. Tina?
I hear you've lost something. I might have a bit of important information for you. Go there and you'll find out more.
Thanks, Tina. Sorry, Dusty, I've got to ask. Why Tina Turner?
Because, Simon, I'm simply the best.
Good one. That's probably just blown your cover, though.
No, I never thought of that.
Tina, come back. Tina, Tina. You got my message then? Yeah, but I'm not quite sure I follow. Someone called Tina gave you a brown envelope. What's in it?
A Bible and a note with a cryptic clue. Find Ned at the Maypole.
I have to say, Simon, as far as carol service videos go, this one is really convoluted. Even by your standards. And it's not even Christmassy.
Look, Dad, stick with it. It's about to get juicy. And there's some Christmas lights up there. I mean, what more do you want?
Fair enough.
Now, any sign of Ned? Ned?
I don't see anyone around. There's Ned's bar. That's probably what the note means.
So it is. What do you think the Bible's for, though?
Not sure. Hang on to it for now. Wait here. I'll go and find Ned.
Eva!
Oh, that was close. That could end up in another scandal. More importantly though, any news?
Yeah, Ned gave me a postcard with a clue on it. So get the Bible out, look up Proverbs chapter 17, verse 12. Ah, here we are. It says, let a bear robbed of her cubs meet a man rather than a fool in his folly.
A man meet a bear? Where in Hollywood would a man meet a bear?
A toy shop maybe? A circus?
Wait a second. Remember last year when we got lost in the country park? Redburn Country Park, remember? Did we not pass a bear pit up there?
Oh yeah. That must be it.
Well, best leave it to the morning then. We are not getting rescued with that PSNI helicopter again, 2 years in a row.
Fair enough.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
Bear pit in here, isn't it?
Well, the bear's the big giveaway.
Oh yeah. Any sign of any clue?
Find it.
What's it say?
Job 3 and 22.
Job 3, 22. Here we are. Job 3, 22.
Yeah.
Which rejoice exceedingly and are glad when they can find the grave.
That's a bit freaky, isn't it? Oh, here, there's something else in the back. Head to the oldest cemetery in Hollywood as the clock strikes midnight, where all will be revealed. Dot, dot, dot.
Ah, that'll be the dead centre of town.
Some wild goose chase this is turning out to be.
I'm beginning to wonder if finding the trophy is really worth all this hassle.
Thank you.
It was you this whole time.
How could you?
Yes, lads, it's me. I orchestrated the treasure trail the whole time.
But why?
To teach you a valuable lesson. The church isn't about winning awards. The purpose of the church, the true purpose of the church, is to be a bright light shining in the darkness. The church is here to show people that in God's kingdom there is joy, peace, and hope. This is a lesson in humility, Trevor. We should be seeking to lay up treasures in heaven, not here on earth. Our purpose is to honour the Father, not to seek glory for ourselves. At the acceptance awards, you thanked almost everybody. The only person you didn't thank was God.
But how do you know that?
Because I was there. Besides, have you ever seen such a horrendous trophy in all your life?
You do have a point there, actually.
So what do you suggest we do with the trophy?
I think I know just the place. Come on, follow me. Anyway, playing that game sort of made up for missing out on the visiting speaker award.
Oh.
Only joking. Or am I?
Oh.